fact that we have such experienced panelists, we got lesser time for audience to do Q&A because all of them wanted to share their perspective. But I'll still say 5 minutes for Q&A, even if the organizers are not allowing. Can we get the mic? Just say your name and address to the panelist whom you want to ask the question to.
I think you can speak without the mic.
Yeah, so good morning. This is Ravi from Hinduja Renewables. So it's indeed a good experience to hear the dais. And most of the speakers here has touched upon the curtailment issue on the grid. So, and it's a high time that as a renewable community, we should act. So one very specific question that as a community, what we are doing and how fast we can see the improvement in grid curtailment issue. And as Vijay says, rightly mentioned, to make our books lucrative, we take very aggressive figures like grid downtime. As in standard, we always take 1% grid downtime. And last week I was meeting the DISCOM people in southern part. And it was surprising that it was coming that the grid curtailment is about 5%. So how is the community taking this and how we are all factoring these numbers in our books? So that's the question.
I think curtailment right now no one is factoring because it's not a very systematic or defined procedure. And in India, industries yet to see the curtailment pattern. It will be more and more in the coming years. Right now, the plants has just started facing it. So it's going to be a question in the coming years, which need to be captured. Right now, I think it's not being captured in any of the models.
Your graph has shown the returns are peaking in the 19th year. It's going down in the 20th year.
Is it like that? That's because of the debt profile. So we've assumed an 18-year debt with the DSRF being released in the 19th year. So that's exactly the point, right? You, the first few years, you're just working towards to fulfill the needs of the lender, right? There is nothing that is coming back to the original equity investor. Only when the lender gets paid off on an 18, 19, 20-year tenor is when you start getting the returns. And even with the lender, there are a lot of reserves that they'll be looking for, which are all incorporated in that calculation.
My name is Sudhakar. This question for Renu. SoftBank. The biggest pain point here is payment coming to the all the service provider or even the ESCOM. How do you suggest we reduce it from today 80% to 8%? What is that you see in the next 5 years?
Sorry, what is this 80% to 8% you said?
No, today 80% people are suffering. Payments are not coming on time. 8 months, 9 months, 12 months. That's the biggest, Because if you have to work on thin razor profit, how do you survive?
So I think people need to see one of the major focus which SV Energy is always pushing to the government and the industry. We are always seeking for a very strong PPA which should give a comfort on the payment security. Plus from the lender perspective. There's no straight answer. Everyone understands there's a challenge. So one need to be very careful which project they want to bid, who's the counterparty, and how they want to handle it. It's a risk perception of each developer. And people need to see, and people factor it in the, their revenue model. It's not like it goes unfactored. So when people are bidding for state X versus state Y, they always try to capture it, those kind of things. So we need to live with that, I think, until the government comes out clean with some real good policies which will enforce this payment mechanism.
I'm Dr. K.C. Mittal, retired from BARC recently. So my comment is basically a comment. We are working on such a big field. There is a definite scope for research and development in this field. We are not talking about that. The single important point is increasing efficiency of the PV panels. Currently, it is 16% to 18%. So there is a big scope to go for 28% to 30%. So some R&D should be done, initiated in our country, and I'm fairly convinced that electron beam processing, radiation processing of panels can increase efficiencies. So I would suggest some of the panel makers to think about it and initiate some projects. If somebody is interested, I can help them.
Thank you so much for the comment, and I think there are sessions next on where our manufacturers are also present, and they should also take it that R&D bit of it should be added. I would now close this session for now.
I really agree with Kapil, and so being an organizer, we organize various forums, and I must say the kind of talks that we have heard today was really very enlightening, and we have not got such insights in a very long time. So I have written few key takeaways, and I'll like to start with thanking all the panelists for making it here despite the busy schedule. Truly I can feel the shift that the story of big plants and getting over, and more emphasis or the sunrise is more on the rooftop segment. Particularly, I'm very happy we started with the first GNNSM targeting, I think, 20 gigawatts by 2021 or 2022. So we've already achieved 30 gigawatts. I am proud about that fact. But specifically, one thing that really worries me is the grid curtailment. And as Mr. Bimal said, that not a lot of developers or IPPs have factored that in their financials. That thing really needs to be taken with the governments at a very high level. So all these issues like bank funding drying up and non-payments are still okay as new funding mechanisms would evolve and NBFCs are coming into play. We all have to see that when we say that solar has achieved grid parity, or you know, solar we are selling at less than average power prices. Let us not forget, it is not just happening in India, it is happening worldwide. And that is why we are seeing more and more markets opening up. Countries like countries in Europe adding big to the demand. Currently, I think the market, which is around about 100 gigawatt annual market, and some large players predict that in times to come, it might become 1,000 gigawatt annual market. So we have to be very careful about the supply chain, the entire ecosystem getting developed. One common complaint about profits being low, I feel it is for everyone, the entire ecosystem, be it for developers, IPPs, EPCs, the technology suppliers, the contractors, and that is probably one of the reasons we saw all those kind of videos. But see, I think all the industry started with the contention that we'll achieve grid parity and we'll be cheaper. And we all forgot about the topic about the benefits or the green benefits of emerging from solar and wind plants. So it's time that some clean energy benefits start flowing in. We're talking about module prices and supply enforcement contracts. I think, already feel that the country is late in thinking about manufacturing and supporting the Indian manufacturers. So, in this view, are we saying is the safeguard of 2 years enough? I think it's a decent time for the domestic manufacturers to gear up, but I think they need more visibility, more comfort, because it's also debatable that will 2 years be enough of the support for them. At the time when I'm saying I'm happy about achieving 30 gigawatts, but also I'm worried how 100 gigawatts will really be achieved. If we are seeing, we are hearing from the large IPPs and developers saying that big plants are having various issues, and the next session is rooftop. So though we are very excited about rooftop since the day one, but there are challenges there as well. But definitely beyond 100 gigawatts, we should seriously think about how to integrate the evolving technologies of electric mobility, vehicle to grid, storage, blockchain, and really make our targets for 24/7 renewable power. So ladies and gentlemen, that's the key takeaways from the organizer side. I'll request for a really big round of applause for all the industry members. And I'll request Mr. Somani to please present mementos on the behalf of the organizers to all the dignitaries on the stage. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. And to lighten up, after hearing so much of positives and negatives since the morning, let's do a 10-minute networking break, and then we'll proceed with the next sessions of the conference.